aliens.
Aliens.
There are good ones. And then there are bad ones. In virtually all science fiction universes where humanity is a spacefaring civilization, aliens seem to be commonplace. Be it, for example, Star Trek. I said Star Trek. That's much better, thanks. Be it Star Wars. I said Star Wars, damn it, not this Disney crap. No, that's Star Wars, thanks a lot. Or Babylon 5, as some of the most prominent ones, and of course many others. The idea is strong in science fiction that alien species are abundant in the galaxy, hundreds, thousands of species in the galaxy alone, often forming alliances and kind of galactic clubs. But how about reality? Do we have any clue what alien species would be like, how they would look and act, and first and foremost, if they even exist?
Today, we wanna talk about aliens!
Aliens!
So where are they? And why haven't we found them yet?
Well, we should be able to see them, right? I mean, we with our sophisticated technology and our high-tech methods of scanning the universe should have totally found something by now, shouldn't we?
Well, many solutions have been proposed to explain this apparent silence. A famous question raised by Enrico Fermi, asking, where are all the aliens? Here at Sci-Fi Instinct, we see this differently. First of all, we assume that our way of searching or looking for aliens should have little results, when in fact, only recently we started looking, a few decades ago. That time span is nothing. Second of all, we are looking in a very, very specific way, which, as it turns out, could be wrong.
Well, we are only looking with radio telescopes for radio signals of a very specific type.
Radio waves! Why don't you look for sound waves? Oh, wait, better. Why don't you look for smoke signs, huh? Smoke signs! Radio waves!
In fact, it hasn't been too long ago where Jim Benford, a renowned microwave physicist, proposed that SETI might have looked the wrong way all along, and that it is far more likely that an interstellar alien civilization would use beacons that be very directed, pulse narrowband radio signals in the 1 to 10 GHz range, instead of unidirectionally transmitted signals. Such Benford beacons would consume much less energy, be therefore much more cost effective, and be therefore more likely to be employed by alien civilizations, because resources are not limitless. Probably not even for them.
So we might have been looking the wrong way all along, and we in our arrogance postulate a Fermi paradox?
Really?
SETI is searching for signals that repeat in quite short time intervals. However, intergalactic Benford beacons would have very long intervals in the area of weeks to months. So SETI might not be looking long enough at one at the same target. These signals would thus appear as solitary signals, one-time signals that are not repeated. In fact, a few such signals have already been detected, where a technological alien source cannot be ruled out as of now.
No, not this wow.
The wow signal was a strong narrowband radio signal which was received in 1977 by the Big Ear Radio Telescope of Ohio State University, the signal lasting for 72 seconds. It was at 1420 MHz corresponding to the hydrogen emission line, which was often theorized to be the frequency of choice for an extraterrestrial transmission, because all technological civilizations should be familiar with the hydrogen emission line. The radio astronomer who first noticed that signal in the data was so astonished that he wrote down, wow. Technology tends to produce narrowband signals, and the signal strength was about 30 times the background noise. It was only observed once, and follow-up observations did not yield any results. However, it remains to this day one of the best candidates for a signal from an extraterrestrial civilization. Much less known is a signal mentioned in a 2010 SETI paper, link in the description, from the direction of the star with a beautiful and easily rememberable name TYC 1220-911, a star very similar to the Sun, a solar twin so to speak, only a bit older. It was even stronger than the WOW signal, 10 times as strong in fact, and lasted for 10 seconds. It was also narrowband, but what makes this signal even more interesting is the frequency at which it was received. 4462.3 MHz, which is the hydrogen line frequency multiplied with the number pi. Coincidence or a carefully chosen frequency in order to mark the signal as of intelligent origin? The signal too, however, was never observed again. But Jim Benford in one of his talks stated that intergalactic beacons would have period times of about 150 days. As far as I know, none of the signal sources have ever been recorded for such long time frames in a row. Therefore, it is not surprising that these signals were never heard again.
We see that some signals were already intercepted, which could qualify as Benford beacons of alien civilizations. However, follow-up studies are still required. But looking for radio signals alone is kind of, well, not too smart. Because they could use lasers for communication, for example.
Captain, they are now locking lasers on us.
Lasers? Lasers can't even penetrate our navigation shields, don't they know that?
Or some more exotic forms of communication, such as quantum entanglement. So the most likely solution to the Fermi paradox is that we are looking the wrong way and haven't been looking long enough. Well, typically in sci-fi, aliens look very similar to humans. In Star Trek, this is of course done in an extreme way, where most of the alien species are basically humans with a slightly modified facial structure. In Star Wars or Babylon 5, the aliens tend to look a bit more exotic. But ultimately, even the weirder looking species have a head, two arms, and two legs. That's still very, very humanoid.
The problem is that we humans simply cannot imagine something too different from ourselves. Let's take the popular gray aliens for example. The number one UFO species. They look suspiciously humanoid, don't they? They have a bigger head, big dark eyes, gray skin, and have very slender arms and legs. Quite suspicious, isn't it? That they are so similar to humans. That in itself shows pretty much that they are probably nothing more than a mental projection of ourselves. As sorry as I am for all the UFO fans out there. Real aliens, however, would be really, really totally different from ourselves. They would look absolutely different in a way that we cannot even imagine it. Kind of like in the movie Arrival, where the aliens look totally bizarre and absolutely different from us humans, that's how it probably would be in reality.
Thank you so much for watching us today.
And let us know in the comment section if you agree with us that the Fermi paradox is an apparent paradox that is easily solvable, or if you think that other solutions to the Fermi paradox are much more likely.
And don't forget to turn on the notification bell, such that you don't miss any of our future videos bridging sci-fi with science.
Next time on Sci-Fi Instinct. Caught the shift type 3 civilizations. Alien megastructures. Alien space fleets. More weird scenes. And the most entertaining UFO footage.
Those are aliens! Oh shit! Fuck. Look at that! They stop! Those are aliens! We can debate it!
See you next time on Sci-Fi Instinct.